Translate and rotate are two functions that are commonly used to change the position and rotation of a game object. In this example, we begin by looking at translate. You can see that the argument of translate takes a vector 3. So this example simply translates down the z-axis, so you can see we've used 0 for x and y, by 1 every frame, because it's inside update. So let's see how that works. It's applied to our floorbot object, and you can see that if I press play, it moves very quickly because it's updating every frame. Now what we'd normally do with the translate operation is to multiply it by time.deltaTime. This means that it will be moved in meters per second rather than meters per frame. Then instead of specifically saying vector3001, we can use vector3.forward as a shortcut to this. And we can then multiply by another value, which we can establish as a separate variable. That way we can control it by using the variable inside the inspector. But what if we don't want this to happen every frame and we want it to be based on a key press? Meaning that it only occurs when I press the up arrow. Then I could do the exact same, checking for the down arrow. This time I've used a negative value of vector3.forward in order to move backwards when I press down. Transform.rotate works in a very similar way, again taking in a vector3 into its argument. This time we're using the vector3 shortcut vector3.up. This represents the axis around which to turn. This is the first argument, and the amount to turn is the second argument. Now we'll add in our variable called turnSpeed, and when I press play, I can move the object around and rotate it using the left and right arrow keys. And again, because I've set these as public variables, I can adjust them without having to go back to edit the script. It should be noted that these functions work on the local axis rather than in the world axis. So where I'm using vector3.forward or vector3.up, this is relative to the axis of the object it's applied to. It's also notable that if you want to move an object with a collider, so something that's going to be interacting with physics, then you should not use translate or rotate. Rather, use the physics functions instead, and you can see these in a separate lesson. The only time that you would want to affect the transform is if you had a rigid body that is kinematic,